So, when the guy counts down to zero, the three astronauts will take off in Apollo 11 from America. And the rocket will fly up to the moon like this and,
Landing module?
Landing module comes off and lands on the moon. And the astronauts are going to come out in their spacesuits. And they're going to get shot in the head by Martians with lasers.
Damien.
And their heads are going to explode. And they're going to fly back to Earth and kill everyone.
That's not going to happen.
It might.
Who's next, Graham? Just a minute, Graham. Melanie?
I haven't done the moon landing, miss.
Thank God.
I've made a model of the telescope and receiving dish in the town of Parks. When astronaut Neil Armstrong lands on the moon, people all over the world will be watching television pictures provided by the radio telescope in Parks.
Mr. Callan, the Prime Minister wants to see you.
Can it wait?
I don't think so.
What's it about?
He's just got off the phone to the White House.
You know who was on the phone just then?
No, sir.
The President of the United States, Nixon.
Sorry, sir, I wasn't...
Thanking me for allowing NASA to use our facility.
Yes, sir.
And something about an upgrade?
Right.
What the hell was he talking about?
There was a briefing document.
You know, I don't read those bloody things. Now, are we raising this in the House?
I think we should.
So what's this all about?
The President was referring to our radio telescope.
Oh, yeah.
Some months ago, NASA requested and you approved its use in the Apollo program, originally as a backup receiver.
Originally?
Well, they upgraded its role. When Apollo 11 gets to the moon, Parks will now be the prime receiving station.
Meaning?
We've got the moonwalk.
Shit. The people in this place, they know what they're doing?
I believe so.
Bloody well hope so. Why'd they pick us?
Turns out it's the largest radio telescope in the Southern Hemisphere.
What's it doing in the middle of a sheep paddock?
The Parkes Radio Telescope, or as we call it, the dish, will track Apollo 11 throughout its journey, gathering voice signals from the astronauts, telemetry from the spaceship, and then, most importantly, the TV signals from the moon itself. It's 210 feet in diameter, it weighs 1,000 tons, and can be moved to a point in virtually every direction. It's the most powerful receiving dish in the world.